Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 13 Public Beta 2 and Developer Beta 3 re-release have been out for a few days, and I've been using them on all of these devices you can see here. My iPhone XS Max has been my primary device, and I've also used it heavily on iPadOS, which is very similar. And also, if you have the Public Beta or the Developer Beta, they're identical in every single way right now. So there's no differences between the two, it's just whichever one you want to be on. Normally the Developer Betas will come out sooner. Now, I've been running it on my iPhone SE and 6S Plus as well. And then also I did a YouTube community poll where I asked you how it was for you and what device you're using. And over 15,000 of you responded, and there were over 300 comments. So I've taken all of that information and put it into a list of things that most people are experiencing, or at least the majority of people are. And then also I'll talk about what my experience was like in battery life and things like that in just a moment. And then we'll cover the actual YouTube community poll and see specifically what you had to say over a few of those different comments. So let's talk about my experience first. And the first thing is, it's actually been pretty good for me depending on the device I'm using. So performance overall has actually been quite good on all of these devices, if it's not freezing. So I do have some freezing, and it seems like Google Apps and YouTube specifically keeps freezing. And this seems to be pretty common across most people that commented on the poll as well, and I'll show you in a little bit. But specifically on the iPad too, and if you're using things like Split View, it will lock up almost every single time. So if you haven't seen that, you probably have, seeing that you are on YouTube like we are right now. Let's go ahead and open one of my videos here. We'll open this video, and then we'll expand it all of the way. Maybe we'll go back to the beginning, and it's working fine right now so far. But let's bring in, maybe we'll bring in news, and then we'll change the size and maybe get rid of it. And there we go. It completely locked up, and you can't even turn it off most of the time. It just dims like this. It will crash, and then we can get back in. So it's kind of strange, but it seems to be repeatable over and over and over. And of course, if you keep having issues, now YouTube may need to update their app, as it seems like Google Apps seem to have this issue the most, including things like Google News and just the Google app itself. So there's something there. I don't know specifically what that's about, but it seems to happen a lot. Now, other than those freezing experiences, I have had a couple of resprings. Actually, as I was setting this wallpaper, it respringed on me, but most of the time it's pretty smooth. Occasionally there's some weird touch responsiveness as far as performance, but most of the time frame rates are quite good. And actually on these older devices like the iPhone SE, I'm surprised how fast it is. Just going into settings here, it does have occasionally that touch responsive issue, but it seems like Apple has really just sped up performance, and I don't feel like I'm compromising using an older device. They feel nice and fast. The 6S Plus that I have here also has the same experience. So unless I'm having an issue with some freezing or lockups, the actual performance is quite good. So no issues there. And a lot of people are saying RAM management is back to normal. So it seems like Apple's still got a lot of bugs to work out, but it's getting better. Now, as far as battery life is not as important on a beta as it is on a final release, because they're still tweaking things. They may still have some processes in the background they haven't cleaned up, but overall, it's actually pretty good for me. Now, battery health on this device is 100%, and I only show you that so that you know that this is basically the best possible scenario. This is a little bit newer device. I have had this replaced. So if you take a look at the past few days here, 6 hours of screen on time, 2 hours and 24 minutes of screen off time. It's quite good for me on the XS Max. Again, the next day, 4 hours and 49 minutes. And over that time, it's pretty good. That's with 20% left or 30% left, depending on the day. But overall, battery life has been really good for me. So I'd say it's not back up to what it was when it was on maybe 12.3.1 for me. But as far as betas are concerned, this is quite good, especially for an early beta. Now, the iPad's battery seems to not have that same effect. I still have an issue with the iPad battery not lasting maybe 3/4 of what it did before. It depends what you're doing. But in general, I'd say battery is okay for an early beta. Now, if we talk about some of the issues you've had, let me just run down these pretty quickly. Now, of course, the YouTube freezing one actually seems to be the thing that many of you mentioned the most. Also, some freezing. some LTE issues, specifically when you turn off Wi-Fi. Occasionally LTE would just drop or your connectivity would drop and you wouldn't be able to connect to data without going into airplane mode and then going back out. So there's something with that and I'm not sure what it is, but it'll be fixed in a further beta or a newer beta by the time it's released. Also, many people mention touch responsiveness and freezing. I haven't had any settings freeze. I have had it respring, like I said, but other than that, it's been pretty good. But the more serious issues seem to be with some people are not able to receive phone calls, and also sometimes iMessage is not working through Apple ID. And then if you're in a car, many people are saying CarPlay is not working. Now, this does depend on the actual stereo you're using, what car you're in, whether or not it's a factory one. But right now, a lot of people are not able to use CarPlay at all. Some other people are saying the apps are not working properly. And also, if you have that Apple Charge case, some people are saying that's not working at all either. There's usually some bugs with the Mail app as well. I don't think I have it installed. It was just too buggy, so I stopped using it. And this is Spark email, for those of you that are curious. And then some people are saying screen recording, if you're using the screen recording feature. Sometimes the audio doesn't work. So those are all the major bugs that you've said you've had, but let's talk about what you had to say in the YouTube community poll. Now, as I said before with the YouTube community poll, there's over 15,000 votes. So I really appreciate that. All of this feedback really helps us get an idea how it's coming along as far as the betas are concerned. And it's great to see that many people respond. So over 15,000 votes, over 308 comments. So as far as the voting is concerned, 13% of you said it was great. 8% said it was terrible, which is actually higher than normal. 26% of you said okay, but many bugs. 15% said okay, but a few bugs. And then 39% of you said I'm using iOS 12.4 beta or no beta. So most of you are saying it's okay, but has a lot of bugs. Now, like I said, there's 308 comments. I obviously cannot read them all here, but I have read over every one of them. So let's go ahead and sort them from oldest first and take a look at some of them. So as you can see, we'll try and cover most of the devices and maybe we'll read about 10 comments or so. So iPhone 7, it's terrible on public beta 2. So again, sometimes the devices can vary from device to device, and this re-release was to add iPhone 7. So it's possible it's really bad. Now, for those of you wanting to use a beta, but kind of afraid iOS 13 isn't so great, you can try iOS 12.4 beta 6. As you can see, it says using iOS 12.4 beta 6 on my primary device, 10S Max. So far it's good, but I'll continue testing it. I had my smart battery on it and it was unplugged at 80% 4 p.m. on Tuesday, and it's Thursday now, and I haven't had to charge my phone since. I'm currently at 23% at 2 p.m. Let's go down and check a few others. You'll see if you look through here, YouTube's not doing so well. YouTube completely freezes. YouTube in books has been disastrous. So you'll see there's, if you go through this yourself, which you can run through these yourself as well, the unresponsive touch on my 10R, I think is what that's supposed to mean. iOS 13 public beta 2 was pretty annoying. I decided to downgrade and wait for the next release. Oh, and if you want to downgrade, I did make a separate video how to do that. iPhone 8 Plus seems buggier than public beta 1 for me. 10S Max, messages, mail, spotlight search, pull down platters, not smooth, and all have issues. Clearing notification platters off the widget screen is not smooth. In the music app, 3D Touch recently played album art blinks and has not been right since iOS 11. Also, the icons on the calendar app when using 3D Touch changes size if you have upcoming events. I've reported all of these and specifically the music situation since iOS 11. I actually haven't had that with the music, so I don't know if that's specific to your device. I'm sure others have experienced it, but I actually haven't seen that. This is Hi Zollotech. It's been quirky for me. Even typing this message, I can barely backspace. It thinks I want to define a word. I have the iPhone 6S, and I'm running public beta from iOS 13, although I updated to public beta 2. It doesn't say on the update page in settings. It only says iOS beta 13. Thanks for asking. Terrible. Yesterday, my iPhone locked randomly, saying that the passcode is wrong. Now I've restored through iTunes, and I have again iOS 13, but the battery life has improved a lot. I haven't heard of that one, but that's an interesting bug. iPhone 10, public beta 2. Public beta 1 seemed much more stable. Since updating, I've noticed scrolling lag, more app crashing, and some apps have become unstable, like banking apps. Can't say I've noticed many improvements. With the first release, it was going great, but with this beta, it's been pretty bad. It crashes a lot. This is on my iPhone XS Max. I find this kind of interesting because with the first beta, it was so bad, I actually just used a different phone. It was really, really bad for me. So this one's actually been better, but it depends on the phone and what apps you're using. It's different for everyone. iPad Pro on iOS 13, and the only app I have trouble with is YouTube freezing. 6S, lots of lag, app crashes, graphical glitches, etc. I don't like iOS 13. My 7 Plus was super buggy and slow on iOS 13 beta. Runs flawlessly on 12.4 beta 6. Very impressed with how iOS 13 betas are going. The second version of iOS 13 beta 3 works really well. I'm using an iPhone SE. App crashes, freezes, screen recording not working properly, voice control not working properly, iMessage is crashing most of the time, slide to type freezes, new emoji stickers at the time making a new emoji, it just stops working, etc. iPhone XS, 256GB, battery life went down, many app crashes. We'll read a couple more here. Okay, but only a few bugs. I'm using iPad 6th Gen and iPhone SE, but my iPhone SE screen is delaying whenever I swipe to the left or right with this beta. Using an iPhone 10, and I keep having this reoccurring bug in which when using the phone, it randomly freezes and black screen with a spinning icon shows, and then it goes straight to the lock screen. Anyone else? I think you'll find quite a few people here have that issue. So let's see if we can find another. Apple Charge case no longer works with iOS 13. Case was for 6, and I've used it for my 6S prior to running iOS 13. iPhone XR, iOS 13, Developer Beta 3. When more than one app is open, there is a small white dot between the battery icon and the Wi-Fi signal. Just noticed it. I haven't seen that one. iPad 5th Gen and has big problems with app updates in the App Store. Freezing and resetting the update progress is normal behavior for this build. So as I said before, there's a lot of little bugs all over the place that people keep experiencing. So that's it for iOS 13 Public Beta 2 and Developer Beta 3 re-release, and also iPad OS. But expect to see iOS 12.4 maybe this coming week. It could take a couple weeks, but it's hard to say. Apple's really changing around their schedule. But I would also expect another beta update possibly early this week as well. It's possible they'll push it a little bit later, but I'm thinking early this week. But let me know what you think in the comments below. Of course, I'll link this wallpaper as I always do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and hit that notification bell if you'd like to see these videos as soon as they're released. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.